Hi, Kevin from Snowy Outdoors here, and this is the CoolMatic CRX 80 litre fridge freezer from Dometic.
Hit it.
Now this is a built-in unit suitable for caravan and motorhome. It has a Dometic compressor at the back and has adjustable shelves in there with enough space for two people for going away for 2 to 3 days or even longer. Okay, before we continue, make sure you like and subscribe because we have a whole lot more to see on our channel. Now let's get into it. Now, this fridge weighs in just over 21 kilos. It is 47 centimetres wide, it is 52 centimetres deep, and it is 64 centimetres high. Because this goes into a cabinet, you now need to allow at least an extra centimetre for width, an extra centimetre for height, and about an extra 5 centimetres at the back. That's for airflow. Now it's an all-steel cabinet. The front and the sides are all the same and has CFC-free polyurethane insulation. At the back here, you've got your compressor. This is a Dometic compressor. Draws between 3 to 4 amps per hour. It's hardwired, which means it's connected directly to your battery. There's no plug there, so make sure you always put a fuse in line as well. This fridge also can be connected to mains power, 240 volt. If you look at the back of the fridge, you've got a socket there. That's the plug that goes in, and that goes into your 3-pin socket on the wall. There is another option for this fridge as well, and that's to attach to a rectifier. What that means is that you attach it both to the battery and to your mains power. The fridge will then automatically select between those two power sources. If mains power is available, that's what it will select first. The mains power is switched off, it'll automatically switch back to your battery. Now, looking at the front of the fridge, to open the door, you lift that bar up and the door opens quite easily. Now, these doors can be left and right hand hinges. So that means if you undo those screws and put that across to the other side there, you can hinge the door from that side or this side. And of course, you do the same with the bottom hinge as well. At the top of the fridge, you have this lock. Now, this has two positions. If I slide that across, you can see it's got a vent written there. Shutting the door, it means it keeps the door open just that little bit, allows air to flow in and out, helps to stop mold from growing. Put it back to its other position, slide it back across, you can see the door shuts as per normal. Now the door has a double catch. You can see if I move the handle, the catch goes up and down. So there's one at the top, another one at the bottom. Of course, the bottom catch hooks into that striker plate down there. Now inside the fridge, you've got a total of 78 litres. You've got 70 litres in the fridge compartment and 7.5 litres in the freezer compartment. On the side of the fridge, you've got your control panel. On our switch there, temperature indicator lights there. Now the fridge will go between 3 and 12 degrees Celsius. The freezer will go between -6 and -18 degrees Celsius. You also have the little fault lights there. Now if either of those come on, just check your workshop manual, make sure you can understand what the fault is. And of course you've got an LED light there which illuminates the inside of the fridge. Now looking at the inside of the fridge, you've got a shelf here which can be drawn in and out quite easily. It can go to different positions. You've also got a shelf down the bottom. Once again, draw that out. You can see at the back there, you've got a little bung. Now, if you take that out, you can screw this little fitting that comes with the fridge. Now, this can be attached with a hose on it, screws up underneath, and any water that might accumulate inside the fridge can be drained away, stops any mold from growing once again. Close that back up again, and you've got a little flap down here, allows you access to getting things in and out there. It also has a fairly interesting little flap here on the shelf. You can see I can lift that up and down. If you want to put a tall bottle in, you can simply sit that up like that. So stand upright, or if you want to lay them down, you can still do that. There's still plenty of room there for the fridge to be, for the fridge door to shut. Now going across to the door, you have a small shelf up the top with a little flap, so you can put little jars and whatever you want in there. That can be taken out and put down there if you want to put something taller. And with care, you can actually take that out. You can see it's very easy. Just be careful you don't break it. Just pop straight back into there very neatly. And then you can put that shelf back up at the top. At the bottom of the door, you have another shelf. This can be removed once again very easily for cleaning and has a nice little slide in here. So if I put those bottles in to the door, I can push that slide across and it holds it nice and tightly, stops it from rattling around. So that's all I've got for you today on the CoolMatic CRX 80 litre fridge freezer from Dometic. If you want to find out anything else about this or any other products, or if you have any questions, go to our website, snowy.com.au, where we have the lowest prices every day.